This is a gift from me to you.
She don't know you.
Yeah.
Hey, I love the artwork on this.
Yeah.
This is supposed to be half cat, half
leopard. Half like
leopard and like and ram.
Deer?
That's not ram.
No,
it's not deer. Definitely not deer. No.
It's like a mystical.
Like a, maybe like a buck. The mystical, oh. The Montour. The Minotaur. Right? The.
The Moomoo Man.
The who? You said the Moomoo Man?
It's like that like deer that's like mystical. Like in, I think it's like in Princess Mononoke. Like the mystical
who?
Deer.
I mean, those are usually like the devil horns, though, the ones that curve in like that. That's usually what they use to portray the devil, those horns. Oh. Well, not always, but like at least typically.
Ooh. He has like really hairy ears.
No, that's a cat. It's not a leopard, is it? It could be a leopard.
Like, look at the. Oh, yeah, maybe I'm right.
Alright, let's get Nocturnal.
This is Disclosure featuring The Weeknd.
Oh, what a surprise.
Don't sound too excited. Everything that he says already, like there's freedom in loneliness and how his shadow doesn't show in the dark, and I love that so much because it just explains why he likes gravitating toward like darkness, loneliness, not around people. It's the only time he really seems to feel free.
Yeah, I mean, if you think about it too, it's a lot easier to hide, right? You can hide in isolation,
but also be free in isolation.
Yeah, you could also be free in isolation because you're free of like.
Like I don't see it as hiding because you can actually be yourself.
You're free of judgment from others is what you're free of, but that's under the assumption that you can't be that way with people.
Yeah.
So it depends.
So in that way you're hiding.
In that way you're hiding, yes. But that's only if you can't be free when you're with others, which is probably hard, I would say, especially for someone like The Weeknd, right? You have an image. Whether you like it or not, you have an image. And there is an image that most artists have to maintain.
But I was going to say that I can relate to this even not being a celebrity, right? Like, I totally feel that way when I'm by myself. Like, I feel so free.
Yeah, no, you're right. Anyone can relate to it. You know, because we all have to be in that social atmosphere. We all have our masks, right? Like, we have to, if you have school obligations or work, there's a certain way you have to act to kind of blend in if you want to blend in. And in your case, I think you're absolutely right. Like, for me, I want to blend in, right? Like, I don't want to stick out when it comes to, like, to work shit. Like, there's no reason to be, I don't know, there's no reason.
Awkward.
Like, just shut down.
Like Mr. Methinks.
Mr. Who?
I don't know. I just randomly thought of Mr. Methinks from Rick and Morty.
Yeah. I mean, it's hard to be, like, truly yourself, like, around people that you're not really close with, right? Like, when you go to work, like, at least for me, like, I can't overgeneralize, but, like, I think about myself, like, when I go to work, I'm not truly myself because I'm not truly around people that I'm comfortable with. Right? Like, it's, I'm strictly, me and you only talk because we both work in this little square right here, or not the square, but this big square, or like this little area. We're only, this is our only relationship. And it can be with your client too. Your only relationship has the purpose to do with whatever transactional relationship you have. And as soon as that transaction's over, that relationship with that person is also over.
See, I used to think that way until I realized that I think it's still a true part of ourselves. It's just a different layer. I forgot where I heard this from, but someone was like, people are like onions, right? Like, we constantly, like, we have multiple layers, but we're still this onion. So I still think that however you are with your clients or people in the public, I still think that it's still your true self, but it's just not the deep version of you.
See, I look at it differently. I don't think that's part of you at all. It's like your clothes, right? Your clothes, they're not part of your identity. That's what you choose to put on. And you can choose to put on anything you want. That's not a part of you. You can, on a week-to-week basis, you can change that outer layer. It's not a part of you. That's an ever-changing skin, I think. I guess you could consider
it. Yeah, because I was going to say it's a reflection of whether, like, how you feel, what you like. So in a way it is for most people.
Yeah, you can definitely make that argument, and it would make a lot of sense. And then I feel like you can also see it the other way, where it's like it's just a mask, the same mask you would treat on Halloween. You're only that person for that day. And that could be the same thing with the act you put on a job interview, or like your first day at school. When you meet someone for the first time, it's very different from how you perceive that person 1 year from that date, because you met them with that mask. And then a year later, you kind of met what I would consider that's actually a part of you, not the persona that you put on that you want people to perceive you in a certain way.
I also think that people change, so maybe it's just natural that you're not going to be the same version.
That's true too, yeah.
And then that's it.
And people change like this song. Nocturnal. My demons are blocking out the light, and my mind is about to lose the fight. Why can't I find peace when a character could sleep tonight? Yeah, your absence isn't something that I choose. Yeah, but the truth is, you were never mine to lose. I like the way he looks at that. Like, you're never mine to lose, right? And I think sometimes when people enter relationships, it's like, it's almost as if they look at it as a gain and a loss, right? Like, when someone comes into your life, you look at it as a gain, and then when someone leaves your life, you look at it as a loss. And you can look at it in a way where it's like, just that experience you have with that person can always be a gain, even if you lose that person. Like, you didn't, like, I feel like you still have that experience that you never really lose. But I guess you can look at it as like a net loss. Because some people like objectify people, right? So it would be.
Yeah. Picture him like singing this like while everyone else is just asleep and like the owls are just chilling in the trees. But I love how the song title is Nocturnal, and the idea behind Nocturnal and how that kind of plays with his relationship experience is that he always sees like the end coming, right? And it's kind of tied to being able to like stay up when it's nighttime, like that, like similarity of being able to see it coming, like the end of the relationship.
Yeah. Nocturnal.
I literally visualize every nocturnal animal like bop into this song. And then Nasi.